The thyroid gland is made up of a collection of structures called follicles. Follicular cells take an iodine, synthesize thyroid hormones in a substance called colloid, and store them. Now, let's make thyroid hormones together. Quiz 1. What materials are needed to make thyroid hormones? Correct. Iodine and thyroglobulin. When thyroglobulin binds with iodine, thyroid hormones are produced. Let's go through the steps together. Step 1. Prepare the ingredients. Let's take an iodine into the cells and transport thyroglobulin synthesized in follicular cells to the colloid. Step 2. Let's oxidize iodine. Which enzyme is used? Correct. It's thyroid peroxidase, TPO. Oxidized iodine binds to thyroglobulin. I will explain this in detail. This process forms monoiodotyrosine, MIT, with one iodine, and diiodotyrosine, DIT, with two iodines. Combining MIT and DIT forms gives us triiodothyronine, T3, with three iodines. Combining two DIT forms thyroxine, T4, with four iodines. Step 3. Stock. These hormones are stored in the colloid, bound to thyroglobulin. Now, let's understand the role of thyroid-stimulating hormone, TSH. TSH is released from thyrotrophin cells in the anterior pituitary into the blood and binds to the thyroid-releasing hormone receptor.
1.
Its activation leads to iodide uptake,
2.
Synthesis of thyroglobulin,
3.
And iodination of thyroglobulin,
and so on.
Step 4. Release. When thyroid hormones are needed, they are taken up from the colloid along with thyroglobulin by follicular cells, cut into T3 and T4, and released into the blood. Quiz 2. Thyroid hormones include T3 and T4, but what's the difference in their functions? Correct. T3 is the active form. T4 is inactive and converted to T3 for active use in the body. About 80% of thyroid hormones are synthesized as inactive T4. When T4 reaches target organs, it's converted to active T3 for use. This process is efficient because T3 is quickly consumed on site. Creating inactive T4 allows efficient conversion to T3 in target organs. Did you understand why patients with hypothyroidism use T4 thyroid hormone instead of T3? Thyroid hormones released into the blood bind to thyroxine-binding globulin or albumin. Some of them remain unbound, free form. Only the unbound free form is active. So when evaluating thyroid function, always measure free T3 and free T4 in blood tests.
Can I ask a question? What does the parathyroid gland do?